Hello students, last time we have explained about the first type of microscope, that is a simple microscope, which is a primitive type of microscope and used to see or to observe the study materials with a less time, less number of magnification, that is just 3 to 20 time magnified image, 3 to 20 time magnified image can just be observed under the simple microscope. So this is a second version of the microscope called as a compound microscope. So today we are going to discuss about the second type of microscope, that is a compound microscope. A microscope magnifies the image of an object. So basically, the microscope is used to see the smaller objects or smaller images or the materials or study materials so as to study the different components of the cell or anything else, maybe the smaller organisms. So a microscope magnifies the image of an object. So this is used to just enlarge the image of the study material. The modern compound microscope is also called light microscope. The modern compound microscope is also called light microscope. It is most important optical instrument. It is most important optical instrument for the study of cells and the tissues. It is also important in a medical laboratory. It needs careful handling. Improper use of the microscope leads to the loss of clarity of the image. Improper use of the microscope leads to the loss of clarity of the image. The light microscope uses white light. The light microscope uses white light, either the external sunlight or the internal tungsten filament lamp, as a source of illumination. While observing under microscope, the objects either look dark or colored. While observing under microscope, the objects or images of the objects either look dark or colored, contrasted against a lighted background. The microscope and its accessories or the components of commonly used light monocular microscope is shown in a figure. All the components of monocular, where we can use single eye to see the image of the object, and the binocular microscopes, where we can use both the eyes to observe or to see the images of the object under the light microscope. So all the components of monocular and binocular microscopes are the same, except that the binocular microscope has two eyepieces. So there is no much difference between the monocular and binocular microscopes. There is difference of only having one or two eyepieces, so as to use one or both the eyes to see the image of the objects of the study material, which allow the user to keep both eyes open while viewing through the microscope. So all the components of monocular and binocular microscopes are the same, except that the binocular microscope have two eyepieces or oculars, which allows the user to keep both eyes open while looking through the microscope. Both the microscope has three main systems. Both, that is monocular and binocular microscope, has three main systems, such as a support system, illumination system and magnification system. So we'll explain these three systems or the components, three type of systems or the components of the light microscope. one by one. So first one is a support system. It consists of following parts. Support system consisting of following parts. The first one, that is footrest. It is used to hold the microscope while transporting. So this provides a good support. This provides a good support of the base for the components of the microscope while transporting. Then tube, it holds, so this is a straight tube, it holds the optical system for magnification. It may straight and fixed. Older models, they are having straight and fixed tube provided with a optical system for the magnification, or may be bent and movable, or may be bent and movable. That is a modern models for the convenient viewing. For convenient viewing, the modern models of the light microscope, they are having bent tube and movable. So tube is movable, provided with the modern models of the light microscopes. The tube has eyepiece. The tube has eyepiece at the upper end, that is near the eye. In case of bent tube, a special prism is put in the middle of the tube where it is bent. So this is the difference of the straight tube or the bent tube. In a straight tube, there may be a magnifying lenses kept in a straight position in the tube just below the eyepiece, but in a bent tube, there is a prism kept in between the eyepiece and the stage. So the tube has eyepiece at the upper end, that is near the eye, and in case of bent tube, a special prism is kept in the middle of the tube where it is bent. The prism directs the light. The prism directs the light beam coming through the objective lenses towards the eyepiece. In a binocular microscope, the light beam further shifts and reaches both the eyepieces. So this is what, again, the adjustment or use of the lenses or the prism kept in between the eyepiece and the objective in a bent tube. And in a binocular microscope, the light beam further shifts and reaches both the eyepieces. Then third part of the support system, that is a stage. It is used to hold the object slide in place for viewing, so as to put the slide or the study material on the glass slide that will be kept onto the stage, so as to view it or so as to observe it by using the eyepiece which is present on the top side. The stage has central hole. The stage has central hole for the passing the light in order to illuminate the object. The stage can be fixed or a mechanical stage can be screwed onto the fixed stage, which can move the object slide across the stage or along the stage horizontally or vertically. So stage is provided with a hole, central hole, so as to pass the light from the condenser towards, so as to focus the object or the study material on the slides. There is a central hole provided with the stage, so as to pass the light or so as to provide the illumination system, so as to focus the study material which is kept on the slides. So the stage can be fixed, or a mechanical stage can be screwed onto the fixed stage, which can move the object slide, which can move the object slide across the stage or along the stage horizontally or vertically. Focusing of optical system can be done either by moving the stage up and down. Focusing of the optical system can be done either by moving the stage up and down or by the movement of limb or by the movement of the limb on the sides, front or back. The support system helps to carry the microscope in an upright position. The support system helps to carry the microscope in an upright position with one hand holding the base. So, support system of the compound microscope consisting of footrest, then straight or bent tube of microscope, and third one, that is a stage which is present between the eyepiece and the illumination system and eyepiece or objective that are kept one below another. So on the top side of the tube there is an eyepiece, then below just above the stage there are objectives of various types which can provide a varied number of magnifications, maybe 10x, 25x, 40x or 100x, that is 100 time magnifications. So these are objectives which are fitted with a tube on the lower end or the arm of the tube. So on the top side there is an eyepiece, and to the lower end of the tube there are objectives, maybe 2, 3 or 4 number, and which are placed just above the stage. So and the stage that is kept, that is fitted with the support system or the arm, handling arm of the microscope. So there is a footrest or the base, then tube and the stage. These are the support system or the components of the support system. Then second is illumination system. This system provides, illumination system provides the proper illumination or the light to the object. It consists of the following parts. The source of light, electric light should be preferably used since it is easier to adjust. It is provided by the lamp placed in front of the microscope. An opaque electric bulb of the daylight type, 60 watts, is used. Otherwise, daylight can be used. So, source of light, where we can use the electric light bulb, usually up to 60 watts, and providing the opaque daylight, or one can use the daylight or the direct source of sunlight also. So, illumination system consisting of one, that is the source of light, may be provided by using the electric light bulb of 60 watts, or direct sunlight or daylight can be used as a source of light. Then second is a mirror. The mirror reflects rays from the light source on the object. So whatever the light source focusing onto the mirror, so mirror will reflect the light rays from the light source of the object, from the light source on the object. One side has a plane surface and other side has a concave surface. So mirror is having two surfaces, plane and the concave surface. The concave side forms a lower power condenser. The concave side forms a low power condenser and used if there is no condenser. If there is no condenser, then one can use the concave side of the mirror. The concave side forms a low power condenser and it is used if there is no condenser. Then thirdly, the condenser. The condenser brings the rays of the light to a common focus on the object to examine. So condenser brings the rays of the light to a common focus or a collective focus on the object to examine, and it is situated between mirror and the stage. Condenser is fitted between the stage and the mirror. It can be raised for maximum illumination and lowered for minimum illumination or light source. The common type of condenser consists of two or three lenses. The common type of condensers consists of two or three lenses. Then fourth part of the illumination system, that is a diaphragm. The diaphragm which is lodged, the diaphragm that is just a black colored ring which is lodged below the condenser and is used to reduce or to increase the angle and therefore also the amount of light that passes into the condenser. So as to increase or decrease the light source from the mirror which is focused onto the condenser. So the diaphragm is used so as to increase or decrease the amount of light onto the condenser. The upper lens of the condenser coincides in a position with the aperture on the stage. The upper lens on the condenser coincides in a position with the aperture on the stage or a central hole of the stage. So this is just a diagram showing the structure of compound microscope provided with a base, then having bent arm, having a joint, so with the help of which we can move the tube or the straight part of the light compound microscope so as to see or view easily. So one can bend the straight tube possessing the optical system of the compound microscope. So microscope provided with a strong base, then provided with a mirror having two sides, that is a plane mirror or a concave mirror, then just above which there is a stage, provided with a central hole so as to focus the light onto the object or the slide from below or from the mirror through the condenser. So there is a condenser in between stage and the mirror. Condenser is also provided with the lenses or the optical system so as to focus the light onto the object. Then stage provided with a clip so as to hold the study material or the slide in a proper position. Then the microscope is having the straight or bent tube or a limb provided with a joint and also provided with two type of screws, one for the coarse adjustment screw and other for a fine adjustment of the image while observation of the study material. Then on the top side of the optical system or the tube, there is an eyepiece, may have variable number of lenses, maybe one, two or more, so as to form a combination of the lenses so as to provide the definite number of the magnified image or the magnification, maybe 5x, 10x, 15x type of eyepieces can be put from the top side. Then body, there is a straight body of the tube and is provided internally with a combination of lenses. Then the lower part of the body tube possessing a nose piece having sockets, screw sockets, so as to fit with different type of objectives, maybe high power objective or low power objective or the 100x or oil immersion objective or even 5x, 10x, or 25x, 40x, 100x, that is low power and high power 10. Low power objective is usually having 10 time magnification, and high power objective is having about 40 time magnification or 40x magnification. So objectives are fitted onto the lower end of the body tube. So this is just a structure of compound microscope provided with a support system, then illumination system and the optical system, so as to observe the images of the object or the study material under the compound microscope or the light microscope. So these are the images of the different parts of the compound microscope. The first one is a stage provided with a stage. This is a advanced type of stage provided with a, or fitted with a screws, that is focus control or the arm, and provided with a, or fitted with a stage consisting of north south control or the east west control of the slides. So this is these two type of knobs, control knobs, are used for the movement of the slides, that is north and south or east and west movement of the slides along the stage so as to observe the study material below the objective. So for the movement of the slides, for the convenience of the, or the proper utilization, proper observation of the slides or the objects or the images of the objects on the stage or the slides, one can use these two type of knobs, which are also accompanied with the stage, so as to move the slide on the sides or to and fro, that is frontward or backward and onto the either sides also, that is north south or east west movement of the slides on the stage. Then second figure representing the condenser, that is a parts of illumination system, and provided with a condenser and a diaphragm. So diaphragm can be rotated, which is fitted below the condenser, so as to increase or decrease the source of light, so as to focus the minimum or maximum amount of light from the mirror or the light source. Then third figure representing objectives. So there are either 10x, 40x or 100x type of objectives, which are fitted with the lower end of the optical unit or the tube, or the body tube of the light microscope. Then fourth one is a eyepiece. So this is kept or put on the top side of the body tube of the microscope, may have variable magnification capacities, maybe 5x, 10x or 15x type of eyepieces, which can be placed onto the top side of the body tube or the optical part of the light microscope. So these are the figures of different parts of the light microscope. So this is again the mechanism. This is the mechanism of magnification, mechanism representing magnification of the image of the object in the light microscope. So this is a magnified image formation in a compound microscope. So the path of the light waves, the path of the light waves to form the real image formed by the objective, the eyepiece sees the magnified virtual image formed. So this is the actual mechanism of the light. This is actual mechanism of the light and the different optical parts or the components which are used in the light microscope, so as to enlarge the size or so as to increase the magnification of the image in the eyepiece. So We can see from the lower side, that is a light source that is focused onto the mirror, which will then pass upward and passing through the condenser and through the hole placed in the center of stage. So that will pass through the object or the study material, and then to the through the objectives there is a formation of real image in the body tube of the optical system of the microscope, then will form the magnified image onto the eyepiece that can be seen through eye, that can be obtained. The real magnified image can be obtained on the retina of the eye after observing the image through the eyepiece. So this is what the mechanism of the light. This is what the mechanism of the passage of the light and through the optical system or the different components of the optical system or the magnification system of the light microscope. Then third, that is a system, that is magnification system. Sorry, this consists of a system of lenses. The lenses of the microscope, the magnification system, already we have explained the support system, then illumination system, then third one, it is the magnification system. The consists of the magnification system consists of a system of lenses. The lenses of the microscope are mounted in a two groups, one at each end of the long body tube. The lenses of the microscope are mounted or fitted in a two groups, one at each end of the long body tube. The first group of lenses is at the bottom of the tube. The first group of lenses is at the lower end or the bottom of the tube, just above the preparation under examination or the object on the slide or glass side, and is called as the object tube. So first group of lenses is at the bottom of the tube or the body of the tube, just above the glass slide or the study material which is kept onto the stage. So just above the object, and is called as object tubes. The second group of lenses is at the top of the tube. The second group of lenses is at the top of the tube, where the microscope or a person applies his eye to observe or to see the image of the study material is called as eyepiece. The objectives, the magnifying power of each objective is shown by a figure engraved on the sleeve of the lenses. That is a 10x objective, 10x, x10, that is multiply. Say this is a symbol of the multiplication. X 10 objective magnifies 10 times magnification, that is a low power. Then X40 objective magnifies 40 times magnification, that is high power, and X100 objective magnifies 100 times magnification, called as oil immersion also. The X100 objective is usually marked with a red or a black ring to show that it must be used with a immersion oil. The greater magnifying power of the objective, the smaller working distance, that is distance between the front lens of the objective and the object slide when the image is in focus. The greater magnifying power of objective, the smaller working distance, that is the distance between the front lens of the objective and the object slide when the image is in focus. So greater magnification can be obtained. The greater magnifying power of the objective is depending on to the shorter distance, smaller distance, or the working distance between the lens, objective lens, and object slide when the image is in a focus. The eyepiece, the magnifying power of the eyepiece is marked on it. The similar to the marking of the power of magnification of the objective, the eyepiece also having magnifying power, and that can also be marked on it. That is represented as X5, that is eyepiece magnifying the image 5 times, or X10, that is eyepiece magnifying the image 10 times, or X15, that is eyepiece magnifying the image 15 times. If you see an X40 objective, with the X5 eyepiece, the object will be magnified by 40 into 5 times. That is, the total magnification will be 200. Getting it? 10x 40, then 10 into 40. So, the magnification ultimately will be 400 times. Or when we use the 100x and eyepiece power 5, then the magnification will be 500 times. If we are using the eyepiece of 10x and 100x objective, then the magnification of image will be 10 into 100, that is 1000 times. So, this is what the calculation of magnification of image of the object with the use of different type of objectives or the different type of eyepieces of the light microscope. The fourth system, that is the adjustment system. The system comprising of the following, that is a coarse adjustment screw. This is the largest screw and it is used first to achieve an appropriate focus. So, at first we use to the coarse adjustment screw so as to adjust the approximate focus or to achieve an approximate focus of the light onto the object or the material, study material. So, first one, that is a coarse adjustment screw. Then second is the fine adjustment screw. So, this screw moves the objective more slowly and is used to bring the object into a perfect focus. So, as to adjust the perfect focus or the clarity of the object. So, as to obtain the clarity of the object or so as to focus the perfect amount of light onto the object so as to see the image of the object in a clear or in a good position, that is the fine adjustment screw. Then the condenser adjustment screw. This is used to raise the condenser for greater illumination or so as to lower the condenser to reduce the illumination. So, there is a screw provided with the condenser also. So, condenser adjustment screw is used to raise the condenser or to lower the condenser so as to increase the illumination or so as to reduce the illumination of the light focused from the mirror. The iris diaphragm lever. The iris diaphragm lever. This is a small lever. This is a small lever fixed on the condenser and it can be moved to close or to open the diaphragm, thus reducing or increasing both the angle and the intensity of the light. So, just below the condenser, just below the condenser adjustment screw, there is a iris diaphragm lever, and which is just rotated so as to decrease or increase the angle and the intensity of the light. Sorry. Then fifth adjustment system, that is mechanical stage control. These are used to move mechanical stage controls. These are used to move the object slide on the stage. One screw that is fitted just below the stage on one side. So there are two screws fitted close together. That is one screw to move the slide or object slide backward and forward, and one screw to move it to left or right. So that is north south or east west movement of the object slides by using the mechanical stage controls or the two screws which are arranged or adjusted just below the stage, and these are used to move the object slides on the stage. One screw to move it backward and forward, and other screw to move it to left or right. So this is the adjustment system. So there are four systems used in a light microscope or compound microscope. That is a support system. First one is a support system comprising footrest or the base, then a tube, maybe straight or bent, and the stage in between the objective and the condenser. Then second one, that is illumination system, possessing source of light, mirror, condenser, diaphragm. Then these are the different parts and the figure showing the structure of light microscope. This is the figure showing magnified image formation in the compound microscope. That is the mechanism of light and the optical system to increase the magnification of the image of the study material or the object. Then third system, that is magnification system, possessing eyepiece and the objective, eyepiece and the objectives of different type. And fourth one is the adjustment system, that is used to handle or to use the light microscope or compound microscope to observe the study material or the object under the light microscope. That is a coarse adjustment screw, fine adjustment screw, condenser adjustment screw or iris diaphragm lever, and the mechanical stage control. So these are the different components of the compound or light microscope, or which are usually used to observe or to study the object or the materials of the different biological objects under the light microscope. Then this is the information which can be followed or used while the use of microscope, how to use the microscope. So while using the microscope, following points should be remembered. Place the microscope on a firm level bench of adequate size but not too high. Screw the objective into the revolving nose or a piece following this order in a clockwise direction, that is a 10x objective, 40x objective or 40 or 100x objective. So these are the nodes screw, there is a nodes, revolving nose, where we can fit or connect the respective objectives, that is 10, 40 and 100x in a clockwise direction. Then place the eyepiece in the body tube. Fix the condenser under the stage. Fix the mirror on the foot. If electric illumination is to be used, place the lamp 20 cm in front of the microscope so as to face the mirror, which should be fixed at an angle of 45 degree. Adjust the position of lamp so as to shine on the center of the mirror. Use the plain side of the mirror. Open the iris diaphragm to the maximum, then raise the condenser. Place the piece of thin white paper over the lens at the top of the condenser, and this piece of the paper should show an image of the electric bulb surrounded by a circle of light. Adjust the mirror so that the image of the bulb is in the exact center of the circle of light, or the brightest part of daylight if being used. It is very important to adjust the condenser correctly. So these are the some of the points which should be followed while using the microscope. Then use the low power objective. Lower the condenser down to the bottom. Lower objective until it is just above the slide preparation. Raise the objective using coarse adjustment screw until a clear image is seen in the eyepiece. Occasionally a clear image cannot be obtained although the objective has been lowered as far as possible. So this is because the fine adjustment screw has been turned right to end. Turn it back as far as it will go in the other direction, and then focus by raising the objective. Then using high power objective, that is 40x, lower the condenser halfway down, lower the objective to just above the preparation. Using coarse adjustment, raise the objective slowly until blurred image appears on the field. Bring into the focus using the fine adjustment, raise the condenser to obtain sufficient illumination. Then using the Eiley Marchand objective 100x, perfectly dry stand preparation must be used. Place a tiny drop of immersion oil on the part to be examined, that is use of synthetic oil which do not dry, as a cedar wood oil dries quickly. So synthetic immersion oil can be used instead of cedar wood oil which dries quickly. Raise the condenser up as far as it will go and open the iris diaphragm fully. Lower the 100x objective until it is in contact with the oil. Bring it as close as possible to the side, but avoid pressing on the preparation. Look through the eyepiece and turn the fine adjustment very slowly upwards until the image is in a focus. If the illumination is inadequate, then use the concave side of the mirror. Remember that the circle of light seen in the eyepiece is called as microscope field. Objective seen at the bottom of the field are actually at the top. Objective seen at the bottom of the field are actually at the top. Objective seen on the left hand side. Objective seen on the left hand side of the field are actually on the right. If you move the slide to the right, the objective examined moves to the left. And if you move the slide towards you, the object examined moves away from you. So this is what a difference of the illumination system or the optical system while observing the object under the light microscope. So this is what about the information or explanation regarding the light microscope or the compound microscope. So today with this we'll stop here, and next time we'll continue with the next point, that is the studies of electron microscope. Thank you.